Beth and Dave in the Morning.
So this Sunday was the Super Bowl, but aside from that, it was the emotional Super Bowl with This Is Us. It was the episode where Jack Pearson, the family patriarch, finally died after a huge fire in their home. He goes in, saves his family, goes back in for the dog, goes back in for some other stuff. Not sure if that's a really realistic portrayal of a fire.
Or a wise thing to do.
Not really a wise thing to do either, but we're talking to Jimmy Mullins, who also happens to be my baby brother, but he is a 22-year veteran of the New York City Fire Department, to get the real scoop on what goes on.
I actually happened to see a little bit of that that episode, and about as non-realistic as you can get.
Oh, boy.
So what is it really like? You've been in fires like this. What is it actually like?
Zero visibility, pitch black, can't see a thing, can't see your hand in front of your face. You don't have a mask on, probably one breath and you're unconscious.
Wow. So you don't run in there holding a mattress for a shield and trying to rescue a dog, unfortunately, right?
Yeah, I'd say a mattress is that's probably one of the most flammable things in the whole house. Probably not a good shield.
So what's the right thing to do in that situation? So I've heard that he did do the right thing and that he shut the door to his bedroom when he saw the flames. And you do that to prevent what?
You do that to prevent the spread. Actually, a simple door holds back an intense amount of heat and fire.
And so, but once you're out, do you ever go back into a fire? I mean, do you ever come across that where people are trying to get back into a fire?
It's actually very common. It seems to be usually for a pet.
Mm-hmm.
And people go back and then, they see these shows and say, I'll just, hold my breath, or I'll just, cover my mouth, or, run real fast through the 1,000-degree heat and I'll be fine.
Yeah, you have to warn people not to do that when you arrive sometimes?
Now, when we arrive, we can pretty much control the situation that they're not going to go back into the building.
Right, right.
So basically what you're saying, Jim, is that not necessarily a realistic portrayal of what it's actually like in a fire. Like, don't go back for the tapes. Don't, take the time to get the pillowcase and get all the jewelry and stuff. Just let it go.
If he did even have a mask and proper clothing on, that bag full of goodies would be melted and it wouldn't be worth it anyway.
Right.
All right, Jimmy. Thank you so much, buddy.
All right. Bye, guys.
Beth and Dave in the Morning.